Hi, my name is Donna McNamara. I am the co-division chief of the Division of GYN Oncology and also a member of the Breast Division. I'm an expert in dealing with GYN malignancies such as ovarian cancer, uterine cancer, and cervical cancer, and I also treat breast cancer. When I started training for oncology, we always talked about the future and what we called precision medicine, being able to take a tumor and then find a therapy that's going to specifically target that tumor. What we currently had at that time was something called just cytotoxic chemotherapy, which kills any rapidly dividing cell. But now we have newer, more targeted therapies that do exactly what we dreamed of all those years ago, are able to specifically target certain pathways, certain proteins that we find on the cancer. The way that we determine this, what those pathways or markers are, is through genomic testing. Genomic testing is a test that can be done on a tumor specimen or even on blood now that looks at these different characteristics and goes through the entire cancer genome. Cancer is a mutation of what used to be a normal cell, so your cancer cell genes are actually different than your normal cell genes. In some of these cancer genes, we're able to find a target. So genomic testing will look for these targets and will match them up with any currently available therapies that are either currently available or experimentally available. There are so many different and exciting treatment modalities currently available that sometimes it's difficult to choose the optimal regimen for a patient. How we choose these regimens depends on so many different characteristics of the underlying disease. I always tell my patient there is breast cancer, breast cancer, breast cancer, and breast cancer. Depending on your type of breast cancer, we choose the optimal modalities with which to treat it, but there are so many different features that we have to take into account. We're always trying to improve on what we call the standard of care. We know what works, but is there something that works better? And that's what our research is trying to define. Is there something else out there that we can either add to our treatments or replace our current treatments with that's going to be better and cure more patients?